I'm Kirk Caldwell, mayor of the city and county of Honolulu. Just want to run down a bunch of things that we're working at the city level. Number one is we have an emergency proclamation drafted and ready to sign. We're going to withhold doing so until we get more information at our 5 o'clock update with the National Weather Service. We are working very hard to clear our streams all around the island. We clear them and they fill up with sand pretty quickly. We're out there again today and we'll be out there tomorrow. Because with this storm, whether it be a Category 1 or a tropical storm, the projection is a lot of rain. And whether it comes close to Oahu or not, as has been mentioned, the track could cover any one of the islands. What we're mainly concerned about for us is flooding along our streams and low-lying areas, both from storm surge and from rain, and therefore we are asking everyone to please pay close attention. We're also looking to identify shelters. We've now identified 7 shelters on city and county properties and 1 in a private organization. The reason for this is we don't want to overly impact DOE. They were so cooperative last time and provided 20 sites in their schools. And of course, it impacted the schools to some degree. And when we gave the all clear, we wanted to get the schools back up for the students to come back in. This time, we thought we'd try to relieve some of that pressure. But it does lead to the question, should these shelters be necessary to advise people in the city and county of Honolulu to locate the shelters? The question is asked, should the schools be closed? And should our workers at the city level go to work? And we're going to reserve making that decision, at least for city workers and shelters, until we get that update at 5 o'clock this afternoon. And we may even delay it till tomorrow, depending, for this island, for the city and county of Honolulu. Our EOC will be activated depending on what we hear at 5 this afternoon. We may go into partial activation this evening and full activation tomorrow, but we're going to wait and see. I want to end, as been said by everyone else, and it's worth repeating, you know, a tropical storm is just as dangerous as a Category 1, and we don't know what it's going to look like as Olivia approaches the Hawaiian Islands. So please, folks, don't let your guard down, please. This is the purpose of press conferences like this. Be vigilant and be prepared. As we say, don't hoard food. Purchase what you need. Think about your neighbors, families, and friends, and make sure you have enough to keep you going for 14 days, and water. And, you know, we see people running off and buying, you know, cases of water. When you have some of the best water from our Board of Water Supply, it's been tested, rated, ranked, you know, so put it in containers you already have. Fill up a bathtub, and that way you're not taxing yourselves. And finally, I just want to thank Governor Ige for calling us together. You know, after our VTC this morning, we had a smaller group get together, and we discussed things that we had not discussed before that I think help us be better prepared. You know, and that's one thing I think we're learning through his leadership, to coordinate both on a county level with the state with the federal, and then with the private sector too. And I think it makes us better each time we go through this. Thank you very much.